everyone to the September 22nd County Board Meeting. We are in beautiful Aurora. We will do a moment of silence, as is customary for the County Board, for those who have been affected by violence, foreign or domestic, and then we'll go into the Pledge of Allegiance. We ask everybody stand and, of course, wear your mask. So we'll have a brief moment of silence. I
pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very, very much. And we're off and running. Attorney, would you do the disclaimer, please? You do it so well, eloquently.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chair. I think I just abbreviate it, that this meeting is being held pursuant to Minnesota Statute 13D.021 and under the emergency order of Governor Walz and the emergency as declared by St. Louis County. And it's the only this meeting is open to the public today. The only accommodation we're making that is allowed by statute and emergency order is that a commissioner, I believe it's Commissioner Olson, can reach us, can join us by telephone. Otherwise, this meeting is open to the public. Thank you.
Thank you. Commissioner Olson, can you hear us loud and clear?
Commissioner, do you have a second hearing? Fine.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, we'll move on. At this time, citizens will be allowed to address the board on items not on the agenda. Speakers will be limited to 5 minutes each. Is there anyone who has signed up or nothing? Okay. And for the items listed on the board agenda or committee of the whole agenda, citizens will be allowed to address the board at the time a motion is on the floor. Moving on, we have the consent agenda. Anyone care to bring anything down?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Would you like to do?
Yes.
I apologize.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chair. On behalf of the 4th District, I'd like to welcome everybody to my lovely wife's hometown of Aurora. And we have representatives here from three government entities. We have the town of White represented, we have the city of Aurora, and also the city of White Lake. So thanks for attendance from those governmental bodies, and we really appreciate all that you do each and every day for the citizens of these three cities. Thank you.
Does anyone from the communities care to speak or say hello?
I'd just like to thank the board for paving all the roads to the south last summer and the guardrails by Twin Lakes. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair, we should take roll call.
Oh, I'm sorry. I can't get used to this.
He pays attention. That's good.
Yeah, he at least Phil's on his game. Yeah, let's do a roll call.
Commissioner Joel?
Here.
Commissioner Boyle?
Here.
Commissioner Olson?
Here.
Commissioner McDonald?
Here.
Commissioner Musa?
Present.
Commissioner Nelson?
Here.
Sheriff Commissioner Yugovich?
Present. All right, thank you. Okay, for the consent agenda.
Mr. Chair, I would move the consent.
Moved.
Second.
And second by Joel. Further discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye. Or no, excuse me, we got a roll call. Even with the it's only October, I'll get this yet with the roll call.
Commissioner Joel?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye. Thank you, Phil. Okay, nothing on the regular agenda, but we do need to recess and convene, consider items passed at the committee of the whole meeting. Okay. Everyone good?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mr.
Chair, we're moving right into Committee of the Whole. Very good, thank you.
Okay. Okay, for the Committee of the Whole, would you do a roll call?
Commissioner Jewell?
Here.
Commissioner Boyle?
Here.
Commissioner Olson? Commissioner McDonald?
Here.
Commissioner Musa?
Here.
Commissioner Nelson?
Here.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Here. Thank you. We'll move on to the consent agenda.
Chair, move the consent.
Support by Commissioner Nelson, second by Commissioner McDonald.
I do want to, Chair Yugovich, to pull down number five under finance and budget and hear an explanation of the reasoning.
Number five? Okay. Just put that after the last number two there. It's under Commissioner Nelson, right? Yeah.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Phil, would you do a roll call, please?
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye. Okay, thank you. Move on to the regular agenda. Under Health and Human Services, Chair Boyle.
Chair Yugovich, first up we have resolution approving the development of the local mental health advisory council and listing members to the north and to the south LAC 20-34. I'll move it to have support.
Support.
Phil, you tell me who did that one. Moving on to Administrator Graham, I think Director Mersch is there also. Mr. Graham.
Thank you, Chair Boyle and Commissioners. The action before the board is to authorize and formally appoint the local Mental Health Authority Council, LAC, and appoint members to that council. This is something that Director Mersch and her team have been working on for some time. We've had a lot of involvement and input and support on the mental health front. This puts us more formally in compliance with state law in this regard, in the sense of having a formal council named and approved by the board. With your permission, Mr. Chair, I'd ask Linnea to come forward and talk a little bit about this, because I think this is going to be a very impactful group of individuals with unique backgrounds and perspectives that will help support and guide one of this board's key initiatives around mental health.
Thank you, Chair Boyle. Chair Boyle, Commissioners, thank you. We are excited. We are on a journey of ensuring that the voices of the people that we serve in our department are really part of the decisions that we're making, and ensuring that the work that we're doing is really meeting the needs. And so, you know, there's not a great job manual, and so I find out from some of my partner directors in other areas how they're using these local advisory committees for mental health, and lo and behold, there's a statute and guidebooks of everything we're supposed to be doing. And St. Louis County had at one time had a local advisory committee, actually had supported a couple, and over time the commitment had really gone away, and yet the needs obviously existed. One of our mental health supervisors told a story about trying to go just this winter before COVID, trying to go and knock on the door where she thought this local advisory committee met in the Duluth. So again, there were north and south ones. And she went, and there were a couple people with lived experience and a couple family members that still went and met together, and nothing else. And no facilitator, you know, nothing else. And so she kept trying to go back, and finally one of the times there was somebody who knew some of the story and said, yeah, the county used to come, and we used to share, and it used to have, you know, a purpose. And so we're excited. We did a lot of listening to people throughout the the region, we worked with Lynn Gert, who has done the needs assessment for the Arrowhead Behavioral Health Network, and so she was really able to kind of add on to that work and listen to what people need and really get people who are interested in shaping the work that's available. So I would just say this lines up well with the work of the Mental Health and Chemical Dependency Subcommittee, Rural Subcommittee that Commissioner Jugovic started this year. As we talk about just what we're doing and what the needs really are, this is another way that we'll be listening. And our role, again, really is to listen. We won't be a facilitator. A facilitator will come from within this group. But we look forward to, you know, listening and using the input to shape the decisions that we're making. Thank you for your support.
Commissioner Boyle, just a quick question. It's hard to know that you can't see us, but so when was the when were these old groups out there?
I think you would probably, Chair Boyle, Commissioner Jewell, I think you would hear different answers from different people, because what was a local advisory committee and when it did it officially end, if ever, and turn into more of a community club or a, you know, so it's not clear. I mean, certainly more in the 80s for sure. But again, there have been pockets of meeting and community for sure for people experiencing mental illness in their families, just not really meeting, I think, the goal of the statute.
Okay, great, thanks.
Chair Boyle, this is Mr. Gray. I would just add to this that there was a Director Bush briefly referenced it, but we get some very good, strong guidance and support from a consultant experienced in this field. But we had over 100 applicants, and there are 28 members, I believe, identified and who are going to be part of the, I guess, the inaugural Local Advisory Council. And I just want to thank all of the applicants publicly for their interest and outreach. It was a very comprehensive vetting process, and we end up with approximately 13 to 15 members north and south with a wide variety of experiences and practitioners and people who have struggled with mental health themselves. This will be with a focus on both adults and children, and I really commend Director Nurse and Gina Bossert and the team that has worked to pull this together. It's really been a great effort, and we've got some administrative work around staggering the terms and formalizing some of the council in the sense kind of from a parliamentary perspective, but I'm very excited that we'll have a more formal and consistent group to help guide us as we support the board in our mental health and human services and our mental health initiatives. So thank you to all who applied, and especially thankful to big thanks to the 28 individuals who are identified in the board letter.
Thank you, Minister Gray. Other comments or questions from commissioners? Well, please just I agree 100% that I've been fortunate to be part of that Clarity Project, being on the county board, and instead spend more of the basis of more of a professional level with our county, cities, judicial systems, law enforcement, and the medical providers. And I think the missing piece was the lived in experiences of those that have been dealing with mental illness or loved ones that are helping people, folks deal with the illnesses themselves. And as the Ministry of Grace said, this has been a top priority for a number of years, the mental health side of things. And I think this is just a nice missing piece of the puzzle that will make our job in the county board easier to know that some things have been vetted through this advisory team. That will do really good work for us. So thank you, Director Versh, and your team for coming up with this. I think it'll be a win-win for us at the board level. Any other commissioner comments or questions? Seeing none, Clerk Chapman, will you do a roll?
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye.
Next up, we have reallocation of social worker to social services supervisor, a 1.0 full-time employee social worker position to 1.0 social services supervisor position, 20-341. I'll move it by support.
Support. Well, let Commissioner Olson give the support.
All right. I'll have the Minister of Grid and Director Mershmer.
Thank you, Chair Boyle. Commissioners, as was indicated by the chair, the action before the board is to approve a reallocation of a social worker position to that of a social services supervisor. I think there are some pay impacts in that this is a three-grade increase or exceeds that, and it needs to come to the board. But more significantly, this reflects the work of Director Mersch and her team to look at two things. One, do we have the right people at the right levels to carry on the work, not only in this case of supervising, but being a voice to our partners and other stakeholders, and two, to ensure that we have the proper supervisory model in place to make sure that our staff are effective and productive. There is a pay impact of approximately $13,000, and while significant, we have also detailed the ups and downs of position adjustments that reflect really Linnea's commitment to looking at how can we do a better job or the best job of targeting the right resources and right skills towards each area. And in this case, this will be a supportive of our home and community-based services division. So Director Mersch is here if there are questions, but we would appreciate your support on this, and we'll absorb these costs into the budget.
Comments, questions?
Seeing none, we'll move this to a vote. Clerk
Chapman,
take roll, please.
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye.
Thank you. Next, we have the item that was brought down under Finance and Budget. Chair Nelson.
Thank you, Chair Commissioner Yugovich. We have but one item under the Finance and Budget Committee for today, and it is to delegate authority to the St. Louis County Liquor Licensing Committee to approve temporary expansion of designated serving areas. I would move it. Is there support?
I'll support.
Supported by Commissioner Yugovich. And I'm going to give the explanation here only because I asked for this, Administrator Gray. And working with Auditor Nielsen, this is, we've received a number of requests from businesses that want to continue to keep their outside serving areas open past the October 30th, or past the September 30th date that we authorized earlier this year. And it's been unseasonably warm. These folks have adapted. They've got heaters and tents, and so they're asking if we would consider allowing them to continue to serve in these areas as long as they can, and to be able to open them up again in the spring as soon as they can, if this virus is not dealt with in that time frame. So I will turn to Administrator Gray, but that's the explanation for why it's here and why it needed to be here today, because the temporary authorization we made earlier this year will expire before we have another
San Diego County Board meeting. Administrator Greg.
Thank you, Chair Nelson and Commissioners. The request before the board is to extend the delegation of authority to the Liquor License Committee, St. Louis County Liquor License Committee, approving temporary expansion of designated serving areas for licensed liquor holders, liquor license holders until October 1st, 2021. I would just expand upon Chair Nelson's comments and discussions with a couple of members of the Liquor License Committee, and quite frankly with the community, that they have adapted, as was noted, and this has become part of a model that is providing some stability to the many businesses out there engaged in this practice. Also, with the ongoing nature of the pandemic and for planning purposes, as they look ahead, rather than have speculation about when and if the St. Louis County Board is going to meet, that for planning purposes, this brings us into next year. We know that the pandemic is not going away tomorrow, unfortunately. And as we look ahead, I think this provides stability for planning purposes for those businesses that will likely incorporate this into part of their business model as, if nothing else, a contingency plan. And knowing that they have the support of the board, I believe this will be a very big positive. So that is the reason for this, and it's really to reflect and provide some assurances to our business community and proceed to extend this temporary expansion of designated service areas through next spring and summer. And again, that reinforces their planning and other forecasting of how to survive in pandemic times. So I think it's very important to them.
Thank you, Administrator Gray. I also would like the board to know that this was vetted with our Sheriff's Department, and they have had no issues related to these expanded serving areas, because that job has been done over the years. They work with these license holders, and this has not been an issue of expansion into these tents and into these other outside serving areas has not been an issue at all. So just for Commissioner's information, it was vetted with the Sheriff's Department as well. Any discussion? Commissioner Joe.
So, Administrator Gray, does this cover, so if somebody were to want to do an additional expanded designated serving area for some event, does that cover that as well?
Chair Nelson and Commissioner Jewell, I believe for special events is still a requirement, but I would defer to either Clerk Chapman or to the chair to confirm that response. But my understanding is this is really to accommodate the lack of seating and to the public health impacts of COVID, and the outside seating essentially is really helping the bars and restaurants to stay in business in a safe manner. I believe that special events still required to come to the liquor committee, is my understanding. And I see some nodding heads, so every once in a while, even the blind squirrel finds a right answer.
Okay.
So, yes, good question, though, because special events are a very different character than ongoing business operations, so I appreciate the question.
Thanks for that.
Anything further? Seeing no further comments, Clerk Chapman, would you please take the roll?
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich, that's all I have under the Finance and Budget Committee for today. Thank you.
Thank you. Commissioner discussion items and reports. Is there anyone who has anything for today's meeting? Anyone at home? Uh, even though you're not a commissioner, I will grant you this leniency. You've been called a commissioner.
You have to take a significant fight in the case were he to take that.
Thank you, Chair Jugovich and commissioners. I just wanted to bring up two things. One is today there is a walkthrough of the at the deck in the Duluth Convention Center that we'll be hosting on a, well, for all significant purposes until we the funding is not available. We'll be hosting a drive-through test, a different type of test, and perhaps Director Mersch can talk to that. But I did want the board to be aware that at 2 p.m. today, between 2 and 3, there is a walkthrough, and the commissioners are invited if their schedule permits. This function, this testing, is this the saliva-based testing? Yeah, so a different type of testing. It's less invasive. And the Minnesota Department of Health is on point, but of course, our public health team, once again, is very supportive, and we've also been supporting on the communications front. This will be available, testing will be available Wednesday through Sundays for the foreseeable future. But I did want the board to be aware that at 2 o'clock, between 2 and 3 today, there'll be a walkthrough if there's any interest by this board. Secondly, I did want to also remind the board and thank Linnea and Laura Birnbaum for their leadership on the Community Assistance Awards. We've identified some tentative recipients. We're ready to go with that. It's been shared with the board. If you have any questions or observations, please share them with Linnea or Laura now. But we hope to announce the awards at the end of this week, pending your review and any other final review internally. So we're very fortunate to have community partners that are so impactful to the vulnerable and those who need special assistance. And this is the distribution of CARES Act dollars to those organizations to help them with the many challenges, financial challenges of the COVID pandemic. So really a lot of work done by Director Mersch, Laura Birnbaum, who's been on point for this, and with tremendous support too from our auditor's office, particularly Kristen Christensen, who's been an invaluable resource as we go through all of these different sorts of award programs. I would add that we've also distributed, I believe, $500,000 to $600,000 of small business assistance grants, the phase one. We are ramping up phase two and encouraging local businesses that have a story to tell from COVID impacts to apply for that. Matthew Johnson and Darren Jablonski and, of course, Deputy Administrator Fritzinger have been very involved, particularly on that side. So a lot of work is being done to find a pipeline and an avenue for businesses and individuals in need. And we're making a lot of progress, and we'll be hearing more about awards in the coming weeks. But this week, please, if you got some observations or questions, otherwise, we're ready to make these community assistance awards to the partners and entities that are reflected in the internal board memo that was sent to you this week, or late last week. So thank you for your support on that. And I have to say, this board, as you continue to provide direction and support, whether it's over the phone, whether it's via WebEx, or occasionally bumping into each other when we can, mass on, appreciate your support of all the folks that are working so hard during these COVID times, not just around the CARES Act dollars, though that's an above and beyond activity, but also as we continue to work hard to deliver services to our residents. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, anything else? Okay, motion to adjourn.
No, we have to have a vote to go back to committee, or board, right? And vote on all the items.
Move to adjourn the committee of the whole.
Yeah, committee of the whole, and then we'll go back. Yeah.
Okay.
Move to adjourn.
Okay, we got a move. Commissioner Nelson has moved.
Support.
Second by Commissioner McDonald.
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye. Okay, thank you. We will move back to our regular meeting.
Move the slate for consent, Mr. Chair.
Okay, we've got a motion by Commissioner Nelson. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Commissioner Jewell. Bill, could you do a roll call?
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye. Thank you. I believe that's it. A motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion by Jewell.
Support.
Second by McDonald. Back to you, Phil.
Commissioner Jewell?
Aye.
Commissioner Boyle?
Aye.
Commissioner Olson?
Aye.
Commissioner McDonald?
Aye.
Commissioner Musa?
Aye.
Commissioner Nelson?
Aye.
And Chair Commissioner Yugovich?
Aye. Thank you, everyone. This meeting's adjourned.
Extremely.